Ministry of Sound presents
25 years of
UK Garage.
We did it again. Get with the get with the drum. Get with the rhythm, get with the drum. Why fight and go along like you now want some of my Liverpool tongue, me your medicine. Get with the rhythm, get with the drum. Get with the rhythm, get with the drum. Why fight and go along like you now want some of my Liverpool tongue, me your medicine.
Garage started in the USA.
There's all different genres of garage. I remember it from being house and garage.
It was more of a vibe as opposed to a genre of music, because at the time it was largely American records that were being played.
Back then people used to play things like 120 BPM. You know, we took it from 120 and brought it up to 130, 132 with our production, because that's how we played them in the clubs.
We took that and it became hardcore. And then you had jungle, and then I think jungle just slowed down and it became UK garage.
There was so many garage events. You know, garage came in and just took over. It was the 90s, late 90s and noughties music.
One of the main reasons why it happened on a Sunday is because for the sort of music we were doing, we could never get a club night Friday or a Saturday. So there was loads of venues on a Sunday.
One of my first real house and garage rays that got me into house and garage was in Pleasure Playground, which was in London Bridge.
People coming from Ministry, across the road, sitting outside an hour, because Ministry used to go until 9 o'clock then.
Frog and Nightgown, you have to mention, because it was one of the first kind of garage events.
I think the Gas Club had going for it. It was one of the late licenses of the beginning of garage, wasn't it?
Yeah.
For garage venues, Gas Club, and also where it was the West End.
Yeah.
The definite rave to go to at that time was Twice as Nice.
And that's when I seen DJ Spoonie and Matt Jan Lamont DJing. And at that point, that's when I knew this is the music I'm going to be playing.
Any scene, and most scenes have a kind of uniform, unofficial or not. In garage, people were just smart. Now, smart may have been leather-soled shoes, or it might have been, at the time, expensive Prada trainers.
And you actually had to have some shoes on.
You had to wear
some clothes.
On the garage scene, it was more champagne. It was people wearing suits. It was an older crowd. Class.
I used to do, like, the slick back hair thing back then. I think people dressed quite elegant.
Yeah,
originally, for garage.
Yeah.
I remember going in a suit and a shirt. I don't think I had a tie on, and when I went to DJ, I took my jacket off.
So 25 years of garage, and it's such a privilege to know that your music, us as producers and DJs, still get big forwards when we play some of our songs that have been made 20 years ago.
I mean, the album, there are so many, like 4 CDs on this album, which, you know, in some ways I'm proud, because after all of these years that we can put out an album and it has so many quality tracks.
My favourite one, if I have to pick one, it has to be, and it's got no lyrics in it apart from like sound samples, is Kleptomaniacs, All I Do, the Bumpy Flex remix. When it goes, baby. No matter where you are, I played at a show recently when I was doing comedy. And as soon as I dropped Baby, everyone at a comedy show just stood up and started doing, yeah, oh yeah, my tune.
I mean, I've had a look at the listing. What an amazing collection of records.
People have been growing up to garage, and it's a genre that I don't think will ever die. The same way rock and roll's here 50 years after.
It is going to be timeless. It's going to be forever.
That's the blessed part about it, to still be here now and talk to younger people, younger generations.
It'll just evolve. Radical's something different, but you can tell it's still garage.
I feel like it's going to evolve, like there's going to be, you know, new offsprings of garage music, but I think it will just still remain garage music.
Garage has that vibe and element. It was UK grown, it had such a massive impact, we will forever hold it in our hearts, and that's why it will never die. You need this in your collection, trust me. 4 CDs, it's going to be big. All the tunes that you used to listen to and rave to back in the days, and even if you're raving now, this is for you.
Ministry of Sound presents 25 years of UKG, out on the 24th of November, 2017. My love.
We did it again.